same distance at both things that we should be able to do, and we do a lot of energy on that. That look just like the point I got in the book. Now the one twist, and this is new this year from what I've taught Ivy in the past, is that they expect you to be using three dimensions also. Now the thing is, the three dimensional ones are no better than the two dimensional ones. You just have to add on a third dimension. So to get a midpoint, you average the x's and average the y's, or you average the x's, the y's, and the z's if you have three dimensions. And to get the distance, you take the square root of the length of each of the sides. If you do a triangle, which if you put it in that formula, it works out perfectly. And then the same thing with the three dimensions. Let's take our time. Couple graphing things, alright? Number one, IV graph paper is really hard to use. We'll probably have to use it a ton on the computer because it's just a pain in the butt to use it. We'll talk about it a little bit here and there because we have to be able to use it. It has tiny little grids. Alright, so when we're trying to graph on the computer, it is much, much better if you use the larger pen. So the third column or the sixth column there. So if I pick this red one, the second one down in the third column there, the red one, I can just put dots on there. And it lets me graph things much easier because the computer does not like it if I try to color. It tends to do that with the box right there because it thinks I want it to open up a menu. Alright, so instead of trying to color a dot in like that, if you pick a large pen, and I have two of them in my menu right there, I can just tap dots wherever I want. That will make your life much, much easier when you are graphing things. Now, a lot of this stuff we aren't going to have to graph because we have a formula for it. Okay, but we always have graphing to take a look at it to see if what we're doing makes sense.